In this example, we are given that a man is standing in a room of length 20 meter and height 3 meter at a distance 5 meter from one wall. And on the facing wall, a mirror is hanging. And we are required to find a minimum size of mirror required in which the man will be able to see complete height of wall behind him. Now, in this situation, to understand, first, let us consider this picture which gives us an idea about the situation. Here, if we consider that AB is the required length of mirror in which the man will be able to see the wall behind him, which is of 3 meter. Then, in that situation, let us consider the image of whole room which is produced behind the mirror. Then, in this situation, we can see if man wishes to see this complete wall behind him. Say, if this wall is AB, then the image of this wall will be A prime, B prime. And to see this, the edges of the wall must be in the field of view of man. So, if this is the field of view of man, here we can see this is possible only when the mirror height is h, and if this is 3 and this distance is 5 meter and the mirror length we are already given at 20 meter, then you can use similarity in these triangles as by similarity. We use h by 5 is equals to 3 by 25. This implies the value of h we are getting is 3 by 5 meter, that is 0.6 meter. This will be the answer to this problem. And here man will be able to see the complete image of wall behind him because the light rays from the edges of a wall when incident on the edge of the mirror will be reaching the eye of this man from both the edges, and if mirror size is slightly less than this, the rays which are originating from the edges of the wall, top and bottom edge of the wall, will not be able to reach the man and his field of view will be narrower than this. So, he'll not be able to see the final image. So, we don't need to draw these incident rays and reflected rays just by using field of view. We can directly get the result. This is the concept which is quite useful for us. Drawn incident and reflected rays just for clarity how man is able to actually see the image of the wall behind him.